Hi there, it's Franny at hobbycrafting.ca. Today we're working with polymer clay. We're going to do this cute little pumpkin here that I promised you guys a while back. It's very simple and easy to do. So these are all the tools you're going to need. And I pre-cut and pre-rolled my clay to make for time's sake. So gonna start with the face, and I've got my little tool here. I'm gonna make two eyes, one there and one here. Then I pick up my little bead here, and actually these beads I'm using are a little bit shinier. Well, they're a different color than the other ones. The other ones are really black. These are more on the bluish side. I like these because they give it a twinkle look. There's one eye. Second eye. There we go. See what that looks like. Now we're going to go for the nose. Little nose in here, and I already pre-rolled my little black ball here for the nose. Actually, I wonder if it's too big. It might be a little too big, so I'm going to cut this down a little bit again. And here we go, and roll it again. Go. I think that'll be better. Okay, here we go. Yeah, it's a bit better. Okay, there's the nose. And then we're gonna make the mouth, and I have my stylo here. Actually, no, I had planned on using this tool right here. That's what I use to make mouth. And I'm gonna actually do a couple here. One here. Oh, I didn't do that right. That's kind of a little crooked smile. Actually, I might leave it. Yeah, I kind of like that. And to give it that little crooked mouth look here, I used a little ball here, and just kind of go in a little bit. Actually, I think I can, let's see, use this here. Oh, this side. That's a bit better. There we go. There, see that? Okay, next thing we do is start with the head. There we go here. And next thing I did was, I made my leaf. You know how to do that. I just use this part here and went through just like a leaf. Bend it a little bit here and put it here in the center. Squish it down, make it roll a little bit. There we go. See that? And I made the stem with a kind of a willow green polymer clay. I'm gonna put this last, there's a little thingamajig here. I don't know what you call it, a little twirly thing. So I'm gonna put that on first. And that goes about here. There we go. That's cute. I like that. See that? There. Okay, now I'm going to put the stem in right behind it. There we go. See that? Look at that. Doesn't take long to make a cute face. Okay, next thing is I cut a pin clip, and I'm gonna use that for the top here. Kind of push it behind there. These work really well. Push it way down there. Move my stem out of the way a bit. There. Okay. See that? There we go. Okay, next thing is we have to put the jump ring. I get these at the dollar shop for really cheap. You get a few, I can't remember for how much, but I'm sure you can find it at the dollar shop too. I think all us crafters spend a lot of time there. I know I do. I live in a very small town, but they have like a dollar shop here, and it's my favorite store, of course. Okay, so now I use this tool. These are your jewelry tools. And you put it at the end of here, and then, oh no, gee, I'm so sorry. Okay, what you would do next is bake it, and once it's baked, then you can add this to it. I suppose you're best to do it that way. So this is what it'll look like. You put that on, and your keychain is done. So right now I'm going to go bake this little guy, and I hope you enjoyed this easy tutorial from hobbycrafting.ca, and so you guys come back again. I'm always doing little tutorials like this. I don't like to spend too much time on stuff, so this is why I make these little tutorials for you guys. So keep coming back for more, and don't forget to go see all the stuff that I've already made at FrannyCreations.ca. So bye for now. See you again soon. Bye.